Hello guys, in this video I will show you how to install the Qt software and integrate it with Microsoft Visual Studio 2022. So firstly navigate to this website, that is qt.io. Now we will click on for developers, and then here we can see the developer version of Qt which is available freely. Now we will download this version by clicking on download try. And then going for download Qt for Windows, here you will see a pop-up form. After filling this form, you will be able to download the Qt software. I have already downloaded it, so I will not download it. I will just open it from my folder section. So after opening it, now I will show you the steps how to install this software so that we can integrate it with Microsoft Visual Studio. Firstly, log in with your credentials that you have made on the Qt website. Now just click on the agree button, just like some simple installation of any software. Click on next. It will take some processing. Click according to your option and then click on the next button. Now click on the custom installation, because we want to install some custom things in this Qt software. Now navigate to the third point, that is Qt, and expand the 6.6.2 version and install the MSVC 2019 versions, both of them. Now click on the next button. Again click next and then install the software. It will take some time because it is of 1.3 GB, so we will resume once it gets completed. So now finally our Qt software has been installed. I will just uncheck all of these options because I don't want to open this software right now, and then click on finish. Now I will open the Microsoft Visual Studio 2022 so that we can integrate it with Qt. I will open any of the projects because project does not matter. I just want to access the extensions tab. So once after opening the project, we will just navigate to the extensions. And in the extensions section, we will just go to manage extensions. And in the search bar, we will search Qt. So here you can see two tools, one of CMake and another of Legacy. We will install both of them. Now we will close the Microsoft Visual Studio so that installation can be resumed. So now installation of both of these extensions has been started. I will click on modify. So in the meantime, I will show you some interesting thing that will help us later in the installation process. We will just navigate to the Qt software which is installed in our Windows C. I will just search here qmake.exe to get the path of this file. So here is our file. Now I will just take out the path of this file where it has been installed. So this is the whole path that we have got. So it is installed in Qt Design Studio Reduce version. Okay, so now our extensions has been installed. Now I will close this window and open Microsoft Visual Studio again. Now I will again open any of the project because project does not matter here. I just want to integrate Qt first. Then again we will go to extensions tab after opening the project, and then go to Qt VS tools. Now I will navigate to options and see the versions tab here. Already my version is showing. If somehow no version is shown here, then just click on the
second plus button and navigate to the right of these. And here you have to select that QMake file that I have shown you earlier. So we will just select that type, that file here. So we have already copied the path earlier. So this was the path of QMake.exe. I will just copy this path and navigate to this path. Now you can see only qmake.exe is shown. I will select this file, and by this method we can set the version of QMake in Microsoft Visual Studio. My version was already set, so I will just remove the other version that I have set. If somehow no version is shown here, then you can follow this step. Just click on OK. And then I will create a new project. In the new project tab under C++ and Qt, you can find Qt widget application. We are making a widget application here of Hello World. This is the first program that we are going to run. So I will just click on next, and then version is showing here. Then click on next and then finish. Then this is the first setup of our project. Here you can see in the source files, I will just navigate to the source files. Then you can see two files are there. First is helloworld.cpp and main.cpp. So in the main.cpp is the code for the Hello World, and in helloworld.cpp is the GUI code, the code that is going to run the GUI for this app is present here. So I will just go and build this app and let's see what happens. So it is giving us some error of build error that is showing that it can't link some lib file. So for this, I have given an extension in the description of this video. You can just go to that extension. I will show you the steps. So firstly, we will see why this error is coming. Let's just go to this path that it shown here. Go to the lib, and here we can see only PRL files are present, no lib file is present. So actually lib file is made from these PRL files by using the CMake on these. So no lib files are present, but I will make your life easier by providing you the lib files. Just open the link in the description, this is the link, and download this lib folder. So after downloading, open this lib folder and extract it here. It will take some time. I have fast forwarded the video so that it happens in seconds and you don't have to wait here in this video. So after the extraction gets completed, I will just open this software, open this folder, and you can find all of the lib files here. I will just copy all of these files from here, and we will just copy paste them to the previous folder that we have seen in the Qt directory. So we'll just go to that directory and we will just copy paste here. So it is copying, and after some time it will ask to replace or skip the files because these are the PRL files that were hosted earlier. So I will just skip these files. So now all the lib files has been pasted in the desired folder. Now I will again run this program and see what happens. So voila, this program has been succeeded, and this is the GUI that we are seeing here. This is a basic program of Qt, and in the next video I will show you how to make some beautiful graphs from the Qt. And that's it for this video. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.